Yes, I'm the foodie here.
Everything's better fried.
Yes.
A gut bomb and a sack of the greasiest fries in Christendom. It's just,
because I think there's nothing wrong with making dessert your dinner or your lunch.
Nothing wrong.
Like hot tea, this has changed my world.
I'm like you, Thai hot. I want to see the face of God. I want those endorphins.
Vegetables, that's what food eats.
Okay. I'll go ahead and say,
is it good?
They have cocktails.
Good to know.
They do have very good
cocktails.
I'll try
that.
Check Please KC is proudly sponsored by Missouri's own 360 Vodka, greening the planet and Kansas City cocktails one glass at a time.
Hello, I'm Doug Frost, and welcome to Check Please Kansas City, the show where regular folks from all over Kansas City dine and dish on their favorite restaurants. This is how the show works. Every week, we have three guests. Each recommends his or her favorite spot, while the other two go and check them out to see what they think. This week, early childhood special educator Leslie Wheeler says she feels like family when she visits her pick in Lenexa, Kansas. Microbiologist Ashley Formanek says her family has been visiting her Claycoma pick since before she was born. And now, financial advisor Aaron Martin says you're always fiscally sound when you visit Sharp's 63rd Street Grill in Brookside.
Sharp's has been here since 1992 in Brookside. Tracy Sharp started it, and in 2003 I purchased it from her. And I've been here since day one in 1992. It's pretty much still home cooking and good cooking and lots of it. Oh, we have chicken fried chicken and chicken fried steak and biscuits and gravy.
It's a fun atmosphere always. Every time you walk in here, there's always something going on. When you come to the bar, we don't really consider ourselves bartenders. We consider ourselves mixologists. We are on top of the game of when a new drink is out. We will be the ones that will probably make it before anybody else here. We have bacon Bloody Marys at Sharp's. We have green zombies at Sharp's. You know, we really push hugs around here too, and lots of smiling faces. Our staff here is great and known for that. When I come to Sharp's, it's always an adventure. It's always a journey. It's always fun.
Okay, Aaron, are you bearish or bullish on Sharp's 63rd Street Grill?
Definitely bullish. It's a fun place. It's a neighborhood institution for
breakfast. Definitely neighborhood, yeah, very much. Yep.
Everybody loves it. I mean, it's got a fun bar atmosphere, and all the servers are great. So.
And so what do you have when you go there? Are you a Reuben guy? Are you a burger guy? What are you doing?
This most recent time, I had as an appetizer the fried green beans, which are really good with the horseradish dipping sauce.
They were amazing.
Oh, you had it too?
Yes.
They're really good, and they're well-priced. So had that to start, and then, of course, the chicken fried chicken with all the mashed potatoes and all the good stuff. So the chicken was really well-prepared. It was crusty without being too hard and too much crust, very juicy on the inside. You know, overall, it was a great meal. It's just comfort food. It's homey.
I went for breakfast, so.
Yeah, so tell us about your breakfast,
actually. That's what I heard. We drove down there, and they said it gets really busy, so we got there right when it opened. And I wish I would have got the Bloody Mary, but I really want a coffee because we got there like right at 8 o'clock. So I was like, oh, the Bloody Mary sounded really good. They said it was infused with garlic and jalapeno and other things. But I got the Crab Cake Benedict, which was really good. I mean, the portions were humongous. But you get two huge crab cakes on top of the English muffin with a piece of ham and then side of potatoes and hollandaise sauce all over. And my husband and I were both so full when we left. And we had to really good breakfast there. Couldn't eat the rest of the day.
It's a good place to take clients because I'll meet with people in the morning sometimes. It's a good place to go just for coffee and a bagel if that's all you want. Mm-hmm. They have the full breakfast, which I've had more than I care to admit. But it's just kind of a good place to linger. There's not a lot of loud commotion going on. There's not a lot of loud music overhead or anything like that. So it's a place to go and have coffee and just kind of linger.
Indeed. Leslie, what you have?
I had the spicy Cajun. I probably would have picked what everybody else picked if I go back, or when I go back. My husband had a hamburger, and it was fabulous.
That's
thick.
My staple when I go back.
Is that right? Just,
wow.
Just straightforward burger,
cheeseburger.
Particular fixings
on
there?
It was perfect.
It's a huge burger
from
what I've had in the past.
We had leftovers, and they have an amazing special. We went on a Sunday night, and I think Sunday, Monday, and Tuesdays, it's buy one, get one free meals. And so everybody else got that, and it was a pan-fried chicken on top of linguine with spinach and tomatoes, and it was fabulous. But my favorite thing probably was the water chestnut soup.
Wow, I've not seen that either. Is this a cold soup, a hot soup? How's this done?
It's a hot soup that I think is a faux potato soup, but it's got the crunchy chestnuts in it, and it was pretty appetizing.
That's the one thing I've never tried, I think. And I've gone there quite a bit.
It's really different. I saw that on the menu. They're known for that, I think it says on their menu. So.
Yeah.
And spicy Cajun, tell us about that dish.
It just was almost like a blackened white sauce over noodles with some chicken, and the chicken was fabulous. The Cajun aspect of it was a little too spicy for me, but it made great leftovers for my husband the next day.
What do you think of the service there? How do you feel about the service?
It was excellent.
There?
They were very supportive. I know that they were helping other people. There was a single or a mom there with a couple of kids, and they were helping her out, and she was having a hard time, and everybody was very helpful, which I liked. And always willing to accommodate you and make sure you were doing okay and kept bringing us rolls. Bringing us rolls was a good thing.
They kind of anticipate what you need. You know, right. If you have a salad, they'll bring you the little cup of dressing, but they'll ask you almost immediately, like, do you want another one? And they'll go ahead and bring that out. So they're real responsive. Like I said, I think any person could go in there and probably if they dine a second time, the servers are going to recognize them. I mean, they seem to know the neighborhood and they're real friendly. So they're just personable people.
And how'd you feel about the service?
Oh, it was excellent. I mean, we got there early enough. There wasn't really too many people in there, but it seemed like, I mean, he was right there, you know, whenever we needed refill on coffee or water or something, and, you know, not too, you know, hanging over us all the time. But, yeah, it was, you know, we didn't have to look for him anytime. You know, we were kind of in and out of there, but, you know, he was always around somewhere, so.
And Aaron, what do you think about bang for the buck?
Bang for the buck, I think, is great. I mean, it's got a lot of bar-type items, bar food items, if that's what you're after, but it's also got full meals. It's not that expensive. I think the two of us ate for less than $30.
And Ashley?
That's special.
Right.
Buy one, get one free special. Right. Okay. That's golden.
Leslie's down with the bang for the buck.
Yes, absolutely.
How about you, Ashley?
Yeah, I think it was pretty good. I mean, the portions were big enough. I think you probably couldn't go there every day if you're just going for breakfast because it was a little more on the pricey side just for breakfast. But, I mean, going there, you know, once or twice a month would be, you know, just for breakfast. I don't know what the dinner would be, but, and drinks would be fun to go there too, I think, because it seems like a hip little spot.
Wonderful. Well, Aaron, it was your restaurant. How do you want to sum it up?
I would say go and try it for breakfast, but if you want a real experience, maybe even go in the evening and experience what's going on in the bar and see all the locals, because that's where they hang out. And as far as food, just anything on the menu would be great. I don't think you can go wrong with anything that you might try.
Ashley?
You know, we would go back. You know, the food, you're not gonna get just, you know, your regular, you know, pancakes and eggs. You can, there's options of, you know, you can get a crab cake for breakfast, you know, mm-hmm. or you can make your own breakfast burrito, and you get a different twist on breakfast. And I think, you know, it's a really nice little place, you know, kind of seems like a local vibe going on, which I really like and enjoyed.
Leslie?
I would say that what I liked most about it was just comfortable. And I felt the food was comfort food, but yet it was more comfort food with a twist because it was also kind of elegant at the same time. It was plated so nicely, and it wasn't just like you were eating mashed potatoes and gravy. You were really eating a nice meal, and with the ambiance, it just set the tone for something fun.
Restaurants close all the time, and Sharp's 63rd Street Grill is no exception. But since they've been successfully doing business for 20 years, we decided to leave the segment in for your enjoyment. Sharps thanks you for your patronage and hopes you continue to support Kansas City's local restaurants and, well, KCBT. Microbiologist Ashley Formanek says she doesn't need a microscope to explain why she's genetically drawn to El Sombrero in Clay Como, Missouri.
Mom and Dad opened the business back in 1964. My father's family is originally from Guanajuato, Mexico. They brought that knowledge and their customs here to the United States through my grandmother and grandfather. Every day we come here at 5:00 in the morning and we prepare the food fresh for each day. When my family makes tacos, we do a different form than some people do. You put whatever stuffing you decide to have inside it, whether it be chicken, chorizo, beef, and you fold them over and you use toothpicks. The atmosphere is family. It's all about family here. You can be yourself. We're not asking you to dress up and be something that you're not. We're saying bring your family here, be comfortable, because we as a family will treat you as part of our family.
Ashley, without going into microbial detail, can you tell us why you love El Sombrero?
Well, I've been pretty much going there before I was born. My parents...
Please define. How is this possible?
My parents went on their first date there.
So what do you like to have when you go there? I mean, you know, it's pretty basic,
yeah,
if you will, but... Mm-hmm.
I try and mix it up. Growing up, me and my sister, we would always get the chicken flautas, and that's one of my favorite things there. You get two of them if you get the platter, and they're just deep fried, you know, chicken, and they're just seasoned really well. And this time I went actually... So I actually got the carnitas and the enchilada. I think I just love fried cheese. It comes on the metal platter and it's, you know, really hot. So all the cheese just cooks on the platter and you're scraping it off at the end trying to get that fried cheese
right,
off.
Of course, yeah.
And that's one of the best parts. And their tacos, and I don't know anywhere else in town that has tacos like theirs. They're hand-pinned tacos where they're smaller and thinner tortilla and they pin the top of them. And you can get Parmesan cheese or Longhorn, which is a different choice, but or you
or
can
put
get
the
both.
Two together. Yeah.
Yes,
I roll that way.
Yep. Yeah, and you can get just regular hamburger, which I get, but you can get their carnitas or chicken, I think, in the tacos. So, and their fried ice cream is my husband's favorite thing.
A little more detail. Oh, you hate it.
I've never had it until I started taking him there. It's like a streusel almost covered ice cream with honey and brown sugar and streusely crunchiness. It is so good.
I think that sounds pretty good. I haven't tried it. I didn't try it. Leslie, did you try it?
No, when we walked in, I heard the waitress say, we only have one fried ice cream left. And I was like, wait, that's probably what I'm going to want for dessert. Instead, we got the sopapillas, which they were the best sopapillas I've ever had in my life. They're fabulous. It's, again, just fried with honey. So it's even, you know, honey and cheese or honey and sugar. It was wonderful. But I loved it. I mean, it was wonderful, and you walked in, I could just tell that people were family there, and I loved seeing the pictures on the wall, and knowing that it was a family business, and it was just natural food. Everything just tasted so fresh and made just with care, which was nice.
Yeah. So what else did you have?
I don't remember which number it was, but I had two tacos and then the chicken and cheese enchiladas and then the rice and beans.
So it's a place where you order by the number.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
You know, let's just lay that out there first.
They are,
I want a number 7, yeah. I don't know, take a number 5.
Everything was wonderful. And then my husband got one of the numbers that included nachos, which I've never been to a Mexican restaurant where you can get nachos with your meal.
It was
wonderful. And it wasn't that fake cheese. It was real cheese. And that was great. The chips were fresh. The salsa was great. I was very happy. I wish it was way closer. I'm like you with Sharps. I wish it was way closer so that I could go there more frequently.
Aaron, how about you? What was your experience like?
It was a different Mexican experience than what I've had before. I mean, I had the chicken flautas, and they were good. They were definitely hand-rolled, hand-fried, all of it. You know, when we first got there, we walked in, and I guess they offer smoking in the front part of the restaurant.
Yeah, they
that's
do.
You one maybe drawback.
So you go to the non-smoking.
Kind of a surprise.
Right. Yeah, and you know, the decor is kind of fun. It's got some old traditional Spanish art, you know. But as far as the food, the flautas they were good. They were maybe a little over-fried for me. We did get the queso dip to start with, and that was really good.
I mean,
it's melted cheese. How can you go wrong? it was very good. And the chips, I think they best fry them themselves there, so those were very good, too. I did have a margarita there.
Oh, we did, too.
The margaritas were very
good. Let's talk margaritas here.
Okay. They were very good.
Yeah.
I don't know what they did to them. They must be squeezing the limes back there or something.
Rocks or up? How'd you do your margarita?
I did it on the rocks, but it had, like, a thick layer of salt around the top, and so it was really good.
Okay. I didn't get one, but I've had them before. I just go there and I know what I'm gonna get. So, you know, water, and they're like, here, honey, you know, you can get some water, darling. You know, you get the darling, the honey, so.
There's a lot of honeys, a lot of beers, and a lot of sweeties.
I loved that. That was the best part.
So, Leslie, do you think it was worth the drive?
Absolutely, and we'll definitely go back. I love anything that's family-owned. And you could just tell when you walked in, the ambience was, this is family-owned and something we take pride in.
How about you, Aaron? Worth the drive?
I would probably give it another try, just to see if I maybe like something a little bit better than what I ordered this time around. But, you know, with some of the other restaurants here locally, I might have to think about it.
Yeah, indeed. Well, Ashley, it was your restaurant. Do you want to sum it up?
Yeah, you got to go knowing that you're not going to get, you know, really fancy dining. You're going to go to this local spot that has been there a long time, and you know what you see is what you get. You're going to get, you know, just the service that you know, somewhere this close to the city, you're not probably going to see the honeys and the darlings, you know, like a diner, small town diner, and, you know, the food, you know, consistently, you know, has been the same for 40 years, so you're going to see the same food, and, you know, what you're getting, you know, some really good homey fried cheese and great tacos, and you know, it's a really good price because it's a working class neighborhood, so it's, you know, a good spot to go for just lunch and for people to just pop in.
Indeed. Leslie, what do you think?
I would definitely go back. I think the thing I loved the most about it is that it was a hometown and people knew each other. They were just conversing, but the tacos, I will definitely go. That's not Taco Bell. I will definitely go back for the tacos. And Aaron, maybe a margarita.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, you can go back for that.
And a margarita.
Yeah.
So yes, and, oh, absolutely.
You got to try the fried ice cream.
Fair enough.
You will.
Okay. And I was just going to say, fried ice cream. Wait a minute.
Yeah.
I think I missed all the good stuff. Oh, I should go back and try those.
We'll take you back.
Okay.
Indeed. Well, try it for yourself at El Sombrero, 79 Northeast 69 Highway in Claycomo, Missouri. Their phone number is 816-452-9745. They're open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner from 7 a.m. They're closed on Sundays. Reservations are accepted, and the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $8. So the wine list is the great mystery for every diner. I mean, maybe you know some of these names, but most people don't know most of the names on here. The wine lists are usually organized by style or by grape or by region, because most of us know maybe not which wine we want to have, but we know we like light white wine or sweet wine, or we like a big, bold red. And you can most of the time look at the wine list, it'll say big, bold red or sweet white, or your server can give you the same information. Just ask the server. Early childhood special educator Leslie Wheeler says her third generation Italian genes fit in nicely at Carlo's Italian restaurant in Lenexa, Kansas.
We opened Carlo's Copa Room in April of 2004. We picked up and moved to Lenexa in 2008. It's a very authentic Sicilian style Italian food. That's all of our family recipes from my mother to my grandparents on both sides. We have a wide variety of pastas made to order. We have a lot of vegetarian selections, seafood selections. Some of our popular dishes are the chicken spadini, the ravioli Sinatra, our seafood ravioli, and you'll always find myself or Lene or my mom here, so don't ever be afraid to ask to speak to one of us, or if you have any special requests on any type of entree or that you're interested in, we can always make it for you.
Because Carlo's Copa Room is where you'll be treated like family. We have great entertainment, great service, and most of all, our food is phenomenal. We couldn't have done it without her.
Leslie, why do you feel like your family when you visit Carlo's Italian restaurant?
The second we walked in, I just was like, oh, I'm at home. And I loved it. It's just a home atmosphere.
So you had not been there when it was the Copa Room downtown. And
no.
So this was a new discovery for you.
A new discovery from a cousin of mine. He said it was the best Italian food he's had in town.
So what do you like to eat?
I've had every single thing on the menu.
Good for you. That's just research.
Yes, research. That's it.
The last 2 years
of research. We actually started going at lunches because you get an unbelievable deal for lunch. You get soup or salad, bread, and your pasta for under $8. Their salads are great, but their soup is unbelievable. But it's like, okay, is it going to be potato soup today? Is it going to be Swiss? Is it going to be, I mean, I don't know what she does, but she can make water taste well. And so.
Any favorite pastas?
Probably the pasta primavera. Mm-hmm. I love the chicken spadini, but the pasta primavera, there's just something about that sauce that...
That's what I had.
Oh, yeah.
It was really good. It had huge pieces of shrimp in it that were not overcooked and not the dry, rubbery type that you might get at other places. I started with the appetizer, and I was kind of surprised. It was the calamari. Uh-huh. I guess they put some type of fried peppers in with it. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's pepperoncini. It was a different twist because it kind of cut down on the fried taste of it, I guess.
Right,
it was a little bit of, and of course the dipping sauce, I don't know if it was marinara or what, but that was good too. You could tell it wasn't out of a jar.
Right, it's her homemade sugo.
Yeah, it's the sugo, exactly. It's mom's
sugo. And it's not sugary, it's just perfect.
It was right on.
Although a little sugar in your sugo is not a terrible thing, but no, you're right. I was surprised that there wasn't a bit more sugar in the sugo, and I was totally cool with that too.
Definitely, and in the bruschetta, I mean, the tomatoes were not just, you know, quickly diced up in huge chunks that are falling off the bread. They're real small and had definite garlic flavor in it. I mean, I was really surprised. I don't think I would have discovered this place had it been suggested.
Was it the location that was giving you the lowered expectations? Or?
No, I probably wouldn't hike over to the Kansas side to go in this place. It's in a strip shopping center.
Yeah, but you don't think that
Right, yeah. Right. It's kind of a hidden gem.
I didn't know it was there. Actually, I've been there in that shopping little center for a while because my dog's dentist is right there. Yeah, we went there on a Thursday night, and they had half-price bellinis, which were really good. That was really nice. We had the fried meatballs for an appetizer, which were really good. I think the only thing about them, and I love garlic, but we were picking out, like, almost whole cloves out of these, and it was almost kind of like raw garlic. So I love the texture, and they're, you know, huge deep fried meatballs.
Usually garlic. It's not that garlic.
Okay, it was, I
devour
garlic.
Them.
I know, and I love garlic. And it was a seafood special that night. That shrimp fusilli pasta, and actually the pasta was cooked perfectly. I love al dente pasta. It wasn't mushy, and the shrimp were seasoned. I don't know, they're so good, and it was like a tomato cream sauce. So that was really delicious.
Indeed. Well, let's talk desserts, shall we?
Their spumoni cake is fabulous. I didn't know that you could put pistachios in cake and make it taste well, but it's perfect.
We were so full. We had enough food to take home, but we ordered two desserts. We ordered cannoli and the spumoni
cake. Well, again,
cake.
You do what you must.
Yes. It's
you
all know, for the
research.
Show.
Taking it for the team. That's
the
all.
Cannolis were good. They were really good. It was the hazelnut cream in there, and it's not real sweet, and there was two in an order, so we took those home and had them about 3 hours later.
We had the cheesecake, actually. We took it home because we were full, and later that night, you know, my husband got it out, and he was starting to eat, and I was like, well, I need some of that too. And
I'm gonna have to talk about it.
It was great, and I love it because it wasn't really dense cheesecake. It was really light, very delicious.
Aaron, what do you think about service there?
They were very attentive. My mom and I were eating at one table, and there was a couple next to us. Their waitress would come over and fill our water glasses and ask us if we needed anything else, so they were very
attentive. That's a pretty good sign, I have to admit, because people have been taught it's not about your table, it's about this whole restaurant and making everybody happy.
Yeah, right when we sat down, and we were talking about this also afterwards, how amazing our waiter was, we really haven't had that great of service anywhere for a really long time, except, you know, really nice restaurants where, you know, you're paying for it. But there, you know, right when we sat down, he asked if we had a Kansas City Originals card, which we do, but no one asks that, you know, only when you're, leaving. So that was like, wow, this guy is really great. It was just a really nice place. The atmosphere is really great and very quiet, low-key. I mean, maybe other times it's, you know, hipper.
Their martini nights are a little bit more hipster.
Well, how does everybody feel about the decor? It's kind of, you know, Sinatra. It's a Sinatra decor. What do you think?
I mean, it's definitely the Rat Pack theme, you know, on the menus, on the pictures, the mosaics and everything.
There's kind of two sections. You can go in, I feel like there's like the jeans and t-shirt section, and then there's the I want to take my girlfriend out on a date section.
And pricing, do you think the dishes are priced appropriately?
Yeah, I think so. My plate, I had the special, I had enough to take home. My husband even had for his small plate, we both took some home. So I thought it was pretty decent. I think the service definitely made up for that. Our server was amazing. So I think that really topped everything off.
And bang for the buck to you?
I've never left there without a meal for the next day. I always get the baked pasta also. That's my second go-to. And that serves me for four meals. So it's like, I'll pay $20 for four meals. That's cheaper than McDonald's, right. So.
And Aaron, do you think it's worth the drive?
It definitely is worth the drive. I would go back and I would recommend it. I think you could go there and eat lunch. I think all the pasta
their lunch
dishes,
is amazing.
They're all under $9, $10, aren't they?
Yeah.
It's definitely worth the trip.
Wonderful. Well, you decide for yourself. At Carlo's Italian Restaurant, the Copa Room, 14944 West 87th Street, Lenexa, Kansas. The phone number is 913-825-5200. They're open for lunch and dinner Monday through Friday, dinner only on Saturday and Sunday. Reservations are accepted, and the average tab per person without drinks is $25.
Check Please KC is proudly sponsored by Missouri's own 360 Vodka, greening the planet and Kansas City cocktails one glass at a time.
So on this week's show, we featured Sharp's 63rd Street Grill in Brookside. Leslie liked the peaceful ambience and the comfort food. Ashley said she loved the different twist on breakfast. And Aaron said the burger is his Brookside staple. And we featured El Sombrero in Clay Como. Leslie said, try the tacos, the sopapillas, and the margaritas. Ashley said they've been serving good local food for over 40 years, and Aaron said he'd probably give it another try. Finally, we featured Carlo's Copa Room Italian restaurant in Lenexa. Leslie said, try the soup, it's amazing and made with love. Ashley said it's some of the best cheesecake she's ever had. Aaron said Carlo's is worth the trip for the food, service, and the decor. Okay, we've had a wonderful time this week. I want to thank my guests, Leslie Wheeler, Ashley Formanek, and Aaron Martin. Please join us next time for three new guests recommending three of their favorite restaurants right here on Check Please Kansas City. I'm Doug Frost, and we will see you then. And let's do a little